complaint is.
No, what I would like is the complaint from the party that initiated the complaint.
So let me clarify a definitional problem. Your, the word complaint is being used in the Oregon Rules of Civil Procedure in a way that's different from the way that you're understanding. A complaint, as you're understanding, is somebody having said, I don't like it, this is going on, this shouldn't be going
on. That is a complaint, and it's clearly stated
in there. One moment. A complaint, as the Oregon Rule of Civil Procedure is using it, refers to a legal document, which is the citation. You can, in that circumstance, substitute the term citation for the complaint, and you will have an accurate understanding of what the import of that rule is. It does not mean complaint as in somebody has said, I don't like this, this is going on. It means the legal document that you were provided that says these are the violations that we are alleging are occurring, and the summons. So it is a matter of linguistics, and
in here it clearly says this is to be taken literally. If we continue down
yeah,
the list,
but why don't you go read the definition somewhere where complaint is defined?
I did.
What's it say?
That it's the act of one party complaining against another, as if to say that you didn't like something. Just the same example that.
But
you
the
used.
County is doing that. That.
The county has provided no evidence of any complaint being issued, which is what I requested
no,
in my documentation.
You have a misunderstanding. And I'm not trying to blunt your efforts. You're an admirable advocate, but you have a misunderstanding. The complaint is what you received from the county. That is the complaint, and it stands as a statement that these are the things that are going on that we contend, we the county contend, violate our codes.
Section 44 of the Oregon Rules of
Civil Procedure.
Right. Say that I have the right to discovery. My discovery is incomplete.
I haven't ruled on that yet. I understand that that's still out there.
Which is what we're basing our continuance on. We need those documents, and I needed that transcript from our last court hearing to give to our legal advisor.
Right.
To prepare defense properly.
It's not there.
Yeah. You understand you have to pay for the transcript.
I did. I paid $37.75, and things are missing. I brought the file that they gave me. I have six copies of the same page.
Officer Walker, what do you know about Ms. Konkin and Mr. McBride's request for information?
I was a part of a number of people, a number of staff from Development Services that sprang into action when we got the request late morning yesterday. And we put together everything we could find about what was requested, which was the documentation from same property last year.
The prior case.
Prior case. None of which relates to what I'm presenting today, but we did our best to find every archived page from that proceeding and then put together everything that would have been handed to them or presented today regarding the case. So I don't know what's missing. I am clear that there are duplicates because we literally went, there were four of us at one time trying to get the pieces together, and there's without doubt, there are duplicates. There are duplicates of your orders, for instance, where there's the financial information from last year and then there's the orders themselves in a separate file, and both were provided.
I don't believe there's any harm in you're getting more than one copy of the same thing. Did you submit your request for documents and information in writing?
Yes, I did, and they requested it.
And where, could I see a copy of that?
I believe they had, they would have the request. There's actually, I filled out two forms, actually. When I came in, the very nice blonde lady handed me one form. I took it home, came back, filled it out. The next lady, brown-haired lady, was there when I came back, said I'd filled out the wrong form. She had me fill out a separate form. So there are two forms that I signed and filled out requesting the documentation.
Counsel, you want to state your appearance, please.
Teresa Campbell from County Counsel's office. Mr. Zook went to his office to get copies of the actual public records request so that we can see if indeed, as Officer Walker stated, it's from a previous case or this case, and that might help straighten out what exactly the defendants received.
Okay. My first interest is in finding out what they requested.
I'll go catch up to him and let him know there were two that she completed.
Okay, so let's take a 5-minute recess while that we get this information pulled together. Okay, we'll be back at 11 after 10. It's 10:13. We're back on the record. Ms. Konkin and Mr. McBride, I have the originals of the documents, the requests that Ms. Konkin filed. One is dated the 16th, which would have been last Thursday, I think, and it seeks, quote, a copy of code cassette file for this property address, and then another request for files and copy. That first was a public records request. This is a second is a request for files and copy, also dated the 16th, paid for on the 20th, and this seeks the box that is checked is copy entire file excluding oversized map. The request states we would like the entire file plus transcripts of every hearing, last year's and the current one. And by last year's, I take you to be referring to COD 2008-00345, which we had multiple hearings on and actually concluded sometime last year. So, first let me ask you, do you have a copy of the CD?
Yes, I have a copy of the CD, but not currently with me.
No, I'm just asking if you've received it. And do you know how to listen to it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then you asked for the entire file of last year's matter, and you agree that the one I just described is the one you're referring to, and the current one. And you are stating that you do not have the entire file.
That is correct. Not to get off course, but seeing how the county brought in legal counsel, I really feel that I can't proceed without doing the same at this point, and strongly ask for a continuance to bring in my own legal representation. Since the county clearly is going to go to their attorney for advice, I feel I need to do the same.
Well, I respect that. I will grant you a continuance for that purpose. I want to figure out before we proceed there, though, what